Hello, welcome to the Hungry Bowl. So today we have a yummy Arabian sweet that is kataif, that too made without cheese. That is, I have filled with custard cream and few walnuts. So let's check out the recipe. So first I have to make the outer cover. For that, I have taken a bowl into which I'm adding 1 cup of plain flour and 1 cup of semolina, 1 tablespoon of milk powder, 1 tablespoon of powdered sugar, around 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, 3/4 teaspoon of yeast. Now let's give a mix. Alright, to this now I'm gonna add some lukewarm water. So at this stage I'm adding around 1/4 cup of water. So add it gradually. Yeah, and the water is lukewarm because we want the yeast to get activated. Alright. So mix it well without any lumps. So that's it. Cover it and keep it aside for at least 30 minutes. Now next, I'm going to make some custard. So as I said before, I'm not using any cheese or milk cream. So I have taken 1.5 cups of milk, into which I'm adding 2 tablespoons of custard powder and 1 tablespoon of corn flour. Well, my stove is still off. I haven't lit it because I don't want it to get clogged up because of corn flour. I'm also adding 1 tablespoon of powdered sugar. Give a mix now on the flame and let it get thickened up. So you can see now this will be the consistency like this. So once you see the bubbles, turn off the stove, and it will get more hardened up once it cools down. Alright. And yes, next I'm going to make some sugar syrup. For that, into a saucepan, add 3/4 cup of water and 1 cup of sugar. Alright. Give a mix and let it boil. As a flavoring agent, I'm adding 1 tablespoon of rose water, or if you don't want too much of, you know, that flavor, you can reduce the quantity as well. So that's it. Our sugar syrup is also ready. So after 1/2 hour, our mix is ready. It has become a bit thickened up because of the semolina. So into that I'm adding a bit more water. I added around 3 tablespoons. So give a mix. And once it is done, now let's make some cutie cutie pancakes. So keep the flame low and pour the batter. Now cover it up and let it sit. It will take around 3 minutes. So we are not flipping it. This should be the color, a golden brown. That now you can take it. Okay. So follow the same procedure with the leftover batter. Make sure that you do the fillings as soon as possible. Or other thing is, you can just, you know, once you are frying the pancakes, make sure you cover up. Because if it gets dried up, you cannot, you know, stick it like this. So that's how I placed a piece of custard and seal it well. Yeah. So, it's really preferable to do this procedure as soon as possible. Okay. So that's it. Do the same with the leftover pancakes. This is one method of folding. Let's check out another method of making a tayaf. Place the mixture. And here I'm not completely closing it, I'm leaving an open space. Alright, so yeah, that will be opened like this on one side. Alright, now to the open. Okay, I have crushed some walnuts, so it's preferably good to use pistachios because it gives a beautiful flavor, of course. So here I've crushed some walnuts and some powdered sugar. So dip the pancakes like this and you can serve it like this. Alright, so it's up to you how you want, or either you can just stuff with the nuts, just the nuts inside the pancakes. So this is another option, that you can fry the katayefs, else you can serve as how you made before, but the frying procedure gives a beautiful texture and flavor to the katayef. So if you are health conscious, yes, of course you can, you can avoid this step. Alright, so our katayefs are ready. It just requires a few seconds of frying. So now you can see the difference which I had fried and not fried. So of course it will be more tasty once fried. So add any nuts of your choice. I've used some walnuts. And yes, this procedure is still incomplete. We have a major step left. So yeah, that's our sugar syrup. So pour it over and let it sit for around half an hour minimum, because I really want the syrup to be, you know, get inside all the katayef. And yeah, so that's it. Hope you liked it. Yeah, in most cases, yeah, it is of course more tasty when you use a cheese, but yes, of course we find an alternative, right? This is also really much tasty, so do try and let me know, and please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye.